The NFL on EA Sports brings us to the banks of the Ohio River and Paycor Stadium in Cincinnati. Coming up, we've got a good one here in the AFC, as it'll be the Kansas City Chiefs taking on the Cincinnati Bengals. We are set to go. Evan McPherson to do the honors, and we are underway from Cincinnati. Now Isaiah Pacheco going to bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line, so bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision, loses him about 4 yards. Mahomes not wasting time. He'll throw. A dump down to McKinnon. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at second down.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. The throw for Tony is intercepted. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. That's kind of a double whammy. I mean, the interception on the opening drive, that's one thing. But to give them this field position, that's another.
Absolutely perfect start for this defense. They take the ball away on the opening possession. They know that their offense will get the ball to start the second half. They line them up in field goal position. And to me, they got a chance for a touchdown right here out of the gate.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Partner, what we're seeing so far is the defense is certainly coordinated. Both levels doing their jobs in tandem. The back helping the front helping the back. The pressure got home on that last play and forced him to try and throw through contact and short of the sticks.
Second and 10 now, Burrow. Incomplete.
Anytime he reads man coverage, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time, they were up to the challenge.
On third down, Burrow. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Trent McDuffie with a pick, and the Chiefs are going to get the football here at their own 23. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Remember last time out, they threw the interception on their first drive. Good news, their defense backed them up, so it's still 0-0 here as they begin their second possession.
Yeah, and one great way to judge a defense, how do they handle what we call sudden change when all of a sudden, you know, it goes against their offense and they have to run out in the field and try and put out the fire. Give this one great kudos for getting out there and not letting that interception lead to points.
There he goes, left side. Down the left sideline. Inside the 20. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Isaiah Pacheco, 73 yards. And the Chiefs take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Extra point by Butker is on target. And that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number two?
Going back to your game plan coming in, everyone has matchups that they like better than others, where they think they have an advantage. Dial up some of those plays. Try and go to those spots and get your offense moving.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Now it's Burrow. And the catch made. It's Tyler Boyd. He's across midfield, and he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. A big gainer there on the catch and run, 37 yards. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
How about that? Red man coverage and decided to test them early. But they've proved up to the task and forced the incompletion.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Burrow will throw. This is caught. It's Boyd. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. From the red zone now, here's Burrow, first down. And he's going to go down. They sack him back right around the 30. And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. Play action. It's Burrow. He gets this one to Boyd. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
That's the third time on this drive that these two have connected with each other. They've got a real rapport going. And right now, it's paying off with big chunks of yardage, as shown by that last play.
Rolling to his right. And that is caught. He's got it for a Bengal touchdown. Drew Sample, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Bengals are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. The Chiefs in good position to start out as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. Pacheco gets it up the gut. And he'll be pretty well stopped in his tracks. Give him a yard up to the 42.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Meanwhile, Mahomes' throw here complete to Kelsey. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. Now the ball on the 30, here's second and 4. Here's Pacheco once again. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Mucked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Mahomes looks to throw on third down. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
From a defensive perspective, they had exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There was pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Well, they'll say no to the 46-yard field goal try. They're going to go for it. Looking to throw is Mahomes. It's Kelsey on the ground. And he is going to have the Chiefs first down as they take advantage of what looked like an unsure defense. They wind up getting 8 on 4th and 3.
On first and 10, here's Pacheco.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. The Chiefs with the football as we start the second quarter, as they've got it second down and 11. Mahomes. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. So he's 3 for 7 throwing the football right now. Not an awful start, but also not the sharpest of starts.
No, I would agree with that. But if you're a confident quarterback and to play that position, you have to be. You just act like there's something wrong with the wind currents or something wrong with the ball. It is not you. Keep throwing. That timing usually develops.
Third down, it's Pacheco. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line.
114 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here in this first half.
They'll run here with Pacheco. And somehow he's going to get a yard out of this as he fought through that first contact. It's second down.
They run it with Pacheco from the gun.
And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. This will be a loss of 3, and now a much tougher third down looming. To throw, it's Mahomes. And it's caught. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down for a nice little gain. They do get 8 out of the pitch and catch. However, it's fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
And not only will he not get in, he's going to lose yardage. They stuff him back at the 4. Here we go. Now Burrow, down around his goal line. Man open, that's Ja'Marr Chase complete. He's got space past the 25. He's got a full head of steam. The race is on. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Ja'Marr Chase, 96 yards. And the Bengals have taken the lead. So from back deep, deep in their home territory, the way into the end zone. Do you think they expected to score on that one?
I'm not sure they expected to score, but they also showed that they're not averse to taking a little bit of a risk there, right? Taking a chance, because the normal call is take care of the football.
Be safe.
Be safe. Instead, they put it in the air and took a gamble, and it paid off in a big way. That wasn't an analytics call. That wasn't a fantasy guy's call. That was like a video game call right there.
It was a little bit of a video game call, but it worked.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone.
And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive.
That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
A solid run on first down, gain of 7, leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
from the 24 now. Here's second down and three. Everybody was up there ready at the line of scrimmage, CD, but no snap, and the delay of game ensued.
Yeah, and I'm sure their head coach is asking the exact same thing. What's going on out there? Almost like they thought they had more time than actually was on the clock.
They are pushed back 5 yards by the delay of game, second and eight. Now here's Mahomes. He'll buy some time right. A good decision in the end. The pull-up run gets him 9 yards and a first.
They made a nice effort to stick him with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
The lane opens up that time as he'll be brought down just short of a first after a gain of about 9. Pacheco gets it again on second down. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there, make the contact, but continue to work your way through the receiver so that he can't possess the football and turn it into a catch.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
The Chiefs on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 6. Mahomes now to throw. We've hit the 2-minute mark in the second quarter, 14-7. Mahomes and the offense staying out there. They'll go for it on fourth. Mahomes throwing on fourth. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out, and the Bengals are going to get it back in terrific field position. Mixon with a first down carry, and he'll be brought down at about the 42. Nick Bolton there on the tackle.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
A second down pass play, though, but it's incomplete. It's rare that a receiver of his caliber would drop one pass, but that's now 2 times he's had his mitts on one and lost it.
Yeah, and I don't think that they're going to lose confidence in him, though, because of the track record. Such a good player, maybe having a bad game, but I think they'll still go to him in a critical spot.
Got a man. It's Chase. He completes it. And all the way in for a Cincinnati score. Jamar Chase. 2 catches, 2 touchdowns here so far. And the Bengals have taken a 2-touchdown lead now. So it takes them just 3 plays here to find the end zone. And you remember, of course, this was all set up by their defense.
Yeah, they got the stop on 4th down. So I imagine the offense said to their defense, thank you very much for this great starting field position. And like you said, 3 plays later, they're in the end zone.
To the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, and this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
Give him 13 yards there and a Kansas City first down. Now a timeout called for by the offense as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. Throwing on first down is Mahomes, escaping the pressure right. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. First down now, but that clock rolling. Here's Mahomes to throw. Open man, it's the tight end, Kelce. Now another timeout called for by the offense as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds to go in the first half. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Operating from the red zone now, Mahomes flush to his right. The ball comes out, and this will get out of bounds at the 2-yard line. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first. Thankfully for the offense, a fortuitous bounce there on the fumble goes out of bounds because they're down here in the red zone. You don't want to lose one there.
You don't want to lose one. And the best part, because it went out of bounds, they retain possession, still have an opportunity to put points on the board.
And they'll get him down just shy of the goal line at about the one. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. Second and goal from the one. Once more, it's Pacheco. And this time, he is in.
Yes.
Isaiah Pacheco, as the first half is winding down. And the Chiefs are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the second time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack. And you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line. And he's able to take it into the end zone.
Butker now to add the extra point. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
Here we go.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue. The run there on first down gets him a yard to the 26. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Bengals set to receive. They have the lead and the football to begin quarter number three. No run back here to begin the half, and we will start at the 25-yard line. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember in that first half, good through the air, and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They've reached the end zone several times. The passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
Yeah, they went to the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
Now problems right out of the gate. We're going to get a delay.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following the delay of game.
Burrow going to give this to Mixon.
And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Here's Burrow.
Got a man open. It's Chase.
And that last reception puts him over 150 yards now on the game, Charles.
And now it's not just execution. It's not just performance. It's a mental aspect that's going on. Because right now, he's got the defense so much on their heels. Got them looking at each other. Who's going to cover this guy? And what type of coverage can we put out there to try and slow him down?
The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks.
The shotgun, it's Burrow. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
Good clean play. No flags coming out of the pocket of the officials. Turns into an incompletion, and that should get him off the field with a three and out.
The Bengals bring out their punter now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And no one there to stop it. Hits at the eight, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive.
And their defense did its job by forcing the punt to start things out. And now, Charles, can the offense get in gear?
I think, Barney, you can sense them saying, okay, first half was theirs, but now let's get the momentum back on our side. We forced a punt. Now let's go downfield and score. If we do that, we'll be set up well for the second half.
Big strides, look at him go. And he's going to be out of bounds here, all the way down inside the 10. And it's straight, it's Pacheco.
And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown.
Isaiah Pacheco.
An 8-yard touchdown run.
And the Chiefs are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Well, they move the ball down the field through the air, Charles, and then finally they get the running game involved, and it works to perfection. Touchdown.
And, partner, I kept waiting for that running game to come into play, and they actually saved it until the very end. Touchdown goes on his stat sheet, but you and I both know, and he knows as well, his teammates airing it out made this a successful drive.
Extra point by Butker is on target,
and we are tied at 21. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And Burrow going to be hit and taken down. They got him. He couldn't get rid of it. He takes a sack for a loss of 6 to bring up second down.
And that flag accepted.
Now Burrow to throw on second down. And that is incomplete.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the gun, it's Burrow. And he's going to be brought down, back at his own 6-yard line. Looks like a 9-yard loss, and it also brings up 4th.
Now here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
The Bengals bring out their punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away.
Here comes Tony on the return.
Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the 5 and keep it moving.
The Bengals bring out their punter now as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time.
On the return, it's Tony. 13 yards, the tally on the return there.
And it's Chiefs football, 1st and 10. So good starting field position for them here as they come up 1st and 10 at their own 42.
They'll start the drive here with Pacheco.
And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
151 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. From just shy of midfield, here's 2nd and 3. Again, it's Pacheco.
And across midfield he goes and into Bengal territory. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
They'll try for the first with Pacheco.
And he'll get it down here to the 43. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on 3rd.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on 3rd down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards.
Come on. A give right side for Pacheco.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12. Now they'll throw with Mahomes. They'll drop this off to Pacheco. 2 yards on the pickup there. And that brings up third and a full 10 yards. Now a timeout called for by the offense. And that's going to leave him with just one timeout remaining, still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt him. We'll be back. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. Complete, the tight end Kelce.
And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 23.
Nice third down conversion and even 20 yards.
We often hear the phrase sure-handed tight ends, and he certainly fits into that category. Plus, he's got a quarterback who knows to look his way when they need a big pickup. And on this play, he finds him for the first down.
On the handoff, it's Pacheco.
And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown.
Isaiah Pacheco.
A 23-yard run.
And the Chiefs have taken the lead here in the final seconds of the third quarter. Extra point by Butker is on target.
And they will take a 7-point lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away.
No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25.
Here we go.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Oh, he'll let one go deep for Higgins.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
But when the running game's not working, sometimes you just got to take a few more chances down the field. That's a good effort, but it winds up incomplete.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. From the shotgun, Joe Burrow. And that will be incomplete.
Give them credit for excellent coverage, tight coverage. They're doing a lot of things that we talk about in basketball. They're causing disruptions in the passing game. And as long as that continues, it'll be tough for them to gain any momentum throwing the ball downfield.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They'll try and throw for it with Burrow. And that one not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. Bengals 21.
All right.
We couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, one score game, first and 10 here.
And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Trey Hendrickson, the one who gets him on the ground.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Short completion, just 4 yards. And now third down and 6 to go.
That was an okay hookup there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
The Chiefs on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. This will be 3rd and 6. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
Oh, nice defensive effort there, providing the hit as the ball got to the receiver, separates him from the catch, and normally he's a sure-handed target.
So a big one coming now for Harrison Butker. This to make it a 2-score game. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. And here's a big one now. Trying to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Now Mahomes. He's got his man, Valdez-Scantling. Touchdown!
Marquez Valdez-Scantling bringing in that one from Patrick Mahomes. And the Chiefs have opened up a 2-touchdown lead here in this fourth quarter. And that's certainly an important touchdown there and makes this a 2-score game.
But as we've seen, no lead is safe in this one with the way these two offenses have lit up the scoreboard. I would imagine that on their sidelines, they're both yelling at their defenses, hey, you want to get involved here? One big play from you, that could win the game for us.
Harrison Butker at kickoff for Kansas City.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away.
And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Bengals drive about to get going. Well, Charles, you remember their last drive. They went for it on fourth down, didn't get it, but you understand why they did in this close game late. Now, though, the road back is even tougher.
Yeah, no doubt about it, and it was fair to look back and say the fourth down was the moment where this one was decided. But as you mentioned, understandable about why they went for it. But, hey, a lot of credit to the guys on the defensive side of the ball. They knew they'd have to defend in that situation, and they got it done.
Buried by multiple defenders on the drive's first play.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Burrow will throw. This is caught. It's Boyd. That one covers 29 yards. First down.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
First down. Here's Burrow.
A throw for Boyd, but it's intercepted. Mike Edwards picks it off,
and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line.
They'll take over first and 10 at the 43-yard line.
So after the INT, here's Mahomes.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly. and knocked it free.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. It's just short. He got 6 of the 7 he needed, so that leaves a decision here on 4th and a yard. They'll run for it with Pacheco. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on 4th. It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the 4th quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down. A handoff now for Pacheco.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown.
Isaiah Pacheco.
26 yards.
And the Chiefs have pretty well put it away here in the 4th quarter. So an important touchdown right there is now they're really beginning to pull away.
Yeah, and this was a tight game until not too long ago. But since then, they've hit the accelerator. And they pushed the lead up to 3 scores here in the 4th quarter. And I don't see them looking back.
Extra point by Butker is on target.
And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21.
Harrison Butker and kickoff 14 to see.
Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And they'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25.
Just another day in the office.
The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. Well, this game, it has had no shortage of offense. They've been able to put up a decent amount of points on this side, Charles. They just have not been able to keep pace with the other offense they're going against here.
Yeah, it's a good way of pointing things out because now it's not a total loss because, as you said, they've scored some points, so there's some plays they can build on, moments where the game plan actually worked. But overall, though, they were just out-personnel. They were going up against a team that's playing at an elite level.
Play clock down to 0, and this is not the way to start a drive. Now the Bengals going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this.
Can't even do it, my girl. I'm Tiffany. Damn, and she tryna cut me off. No, she cannot do it. No, she cannot listen to me. get it started, pull up in the U-Haul, you get your move on. And they know they ain't seeing us. You pull your pin in a double cup. Wanna step at yourself, are you good enough? Wanna step at yourself, are you hood enough? If I hear them kids, know you pulling up. And now you laid out, ain't no getting up. I'm with your girl in the bathroom, and it sound like shit. I tried that little boy, ain't no getting up. Shorty, your horsey, I told her they. My young city, yo. The granny, I had to tell her, pick it. You wanna feed, not anything under 18, just like. She like 5'3", I think it ain't Lydia. Ignoring unstoppable, man, it's impossible to stop as we for sure on the road. Stay to myself, stay off the medium, chilling, ain't gonna play with the trolls. Going 100 in the I-8, I pray to God we don't lose control. Know I'm on a paper chase, my little whip on cruise control.
I can get it gone in a blink.
Stack money.
We can make a from the same
money.
He can make a call if you tweet.
Black money.
I can make a ball when I speak.
Rap money.
Brother used to hide a hundred. The hashback partner used to bust a couple scams off of Snapchat. Shorty trying to come up on the bands cause of that. We don't give a Uncle Sam if you ask that. Where the money in the middle. Boy, I just solved the riddle for this pound cake. Giggles, now I see fiddle all around me. He little, my head was on a swivel. He was pushing the rental. Ain't it coincidental? He ain't really talking money. Who he talking to? Homie hopping, need a, they all some. I can charge a band to get a glimpse of what I'm about to do. They be talking to every about what they ought to do. I ain't tripping off of nothing. My name is Topic Discussion. If I give them attention, they all would probably start blushing.